Buyers, the state of the real estate market, my thoughts. Welcome back to I Buy Real Estate, your free step-by-step guide so you can buy real estate. With what is going on in today's events, COVID, protests, looters, elections, the real estate market is at an all-time high. I mean, it shouldn't be like this. Here's why. One, the Fed have reduced interest rates so low, which attracts buyers and buyers. Two, evictions and foreclosures are halted, so the only way to buy houses is directly from sellers. Three, many sellers are not comfortable showing the house and moving during COVID times. I have buyers buying properties blind. Yes, blind. What do you mean blind? I mean, they don't even need to see the inside. The other day, I showed the buyer a house from the outside, and he said, I'll take it. Gave me the deposit check and ready to close. If you got inventory right now, you're winning. So basically, economics 101, supply and demand. When the demand is high and supply is low, prices increased. When the demand is low and the supply is high, prices decreased. And this relates to any product, doesn't have to be real estate. It can be cars, beer, toilet paper. Speaking of toilet paper, 8 people arrested in California for reselling toilet paper and hand sanitizer at ridiculous prices. They know these are necessity items, so when COVID hit and everyone was panicking, low supply, high demand can sell at a higher price than normal. Now let's take a look at the real estate market stats. So if you take a look, the whole region for US February 2020 versus last year, it went up 7.2%. However, that's before all the craziness happened. So I think it all started around June, maybe even May. So I think that number right now went up to at least 15%. And that's just what I'm seeing in the market today. And that's the home sales. Now, if you take a look at the median price for US, it went up 8%, and that's based off February's. But if you take a look at June and July, where there's so much buyers right now, so many buyers, it's at least 15-20% versus last year. And the reason I'm saying this is because I have realtor friends telling me every offer they've been putting on houses, they're seeing like 20 to 30 different offers. And the other day, my realtor just told me he put an offer $30,000 over asking, and he lost it. It's crazy. So what does that mean for buyers and sellers? So sellers, you have no problem to sell your house and probably over asking. Now is the best time to sell if you want to unload any property. Buyers, interest rates as low as 2.97%. That basically feels like you're living for free. Go out and buy a 2-4 unit to capitalize on this opportunity. Not to mention, you should be generating some pretty good cash flow monthly. Now, will this market trend continue? My prediction is that it will continue to the point until foreclosures and evictions are opened back up. Then slowly it will start to shift from a high demand to equilibrium. The Fed will eventually raise interest rates to the point it will make more sense renting instead of owning a home. At that point, supply will be high and demand will be low, and I wouldn't be surprised if this happened after elections. So be prepared. That's it. If you are entertained or got value, make sure to click the like button so it turns blue, because I really put a lot of effort and research into making these videos, and subscribe for more free helpful content. If you got any questions or want to share your thoughts on this crazy market frenzy, make sure to comment below and share to help others just like yourself. I'll see you on the next one.